our property explainer today, we look at what conveyance deed is. This is an important term to understand because no property purchase can be completed without a valid conveyance deed. Sunil Tyagi, senior partner and co-founder of Zeus Law, joins us to decode this term for us and tell us why it's important. So Sunil, let's start with a simple explanation of what a conveyance deed stands for and why a sale deed is not enough if you're buying a home.
So Manisha, conveyance is basically a transfer of a property where legal title is transferred from one person to another person. So conveyance means any transfer of immovable or movable property, and it can be in any form. So it just has to be a transfer. Convey means only transfer of title from one person to another person. That is called conveyance deed.
All right. So you're saying a lot of people are a little confused about what a sale deed is and what a conveyance deed is. So you're saying a sale deed does not actually imply that you have a legal right or the property has been transferred in your name.
No, sale deed is one of the form of a conveyance deed. Conveyance means transfer of title. It could be in the form of a gift. It could be in the form of an exchange. It could be in the form of a sale deed. So every sale is a conveyance, but it doesn't mean that every conveyance is a sale. So sale deed is enough. In case it is for consideration, then you transfer a title by buying a property or selling a property. That is called sale deed. So sale deed is one of the form of a conveyance deed. Sale deed in itself is good enough for transfer of a title.
It is good enough. So you're saying a conveyance deed is not a required document to make sure that the property is owned by you?
No, it is not required. In Delhi, it's just used only for the purposes when a leasehold property from a perpetual lease is converted into a freehold, then DDA executes a conveyance deed. So in practice in Delhi, conveyance deed is only executed for that. Otherwise, either it is a gift deed or an exchange deed or a sale deed or any other form of a transfer of property.
Mm-hmm. So then let's come to both, whether it's a sale deed or a conveyance deed. What are some of the things that a buyer must keep in mind that the deed must have and shouldn't be missed out?
So it depends on the nature of the transaction if it is a sale deed. So in the sale deed, the foremost thing is what you are buying and selling. That should be clearly spelled out, demarcated, and maybe shown in a layout plan to clearly identify a property. The commercial terms of buying and selling, what is the price, should be clearly captured. The time period should be clearly captured. So these are the things which are necessary to be captured in a sale deed. For a gift deed, again, there is no consideration. Therefore, there is no mention of a amount which is being paid or received. It's pure gift out of love and affection. The description of the property, the details of the donor, donee should be clearly captured. So it depends on the nature of the transaction and the document you are entering into. That should be clearly specified and captured in a document.
Sunil Tyagi, thank you very much for explaining that to us and for all our audience and viewers. Just recapping, what conveyance refers to is the act of transferring the title, ownership, rights and interest in a property from one entity to another. The term deed refers to an instrument like a written document that is signed by all the parties to a contract. In this case, of course, it's a seller and the buyer. It's a binding contract that is enforceable in a court of law. So therefore, it's a contract in which the seller will actually transfer all rights to the legal owner, and the purchase of a property is sometimes not considered completed without a valid conveyance deed. But in most cases, a sale deed suffices. Well, that's a wrap on the Property Show. I'll see you same time again next week.